So it's 2021, and what if I told you that there's a brand new kids show that features the everyday adventures of a man and his giant penis? That's right, you heard it correctly. Giant penis. Well, from the great minds who brought us Miffy and Mannequin Peace comes John Dillermand. John Dillermand is a brand new kids show that debuted this past weekend that features the everyday exploits of John, who lives with his mom or grandma, I don't know, some lady, and his penis. And basically him and his penis get into a bunch of shenanigans all throughout the episode and throughout the season. And I took some time to review the entire season. And here's a brief rundown of what you get to see. I mean, it's 13 episodes long. And each episode is roughly like around 5 minutes, so not that long. And I was able to watch through them all, and it's quite interesting, I have to say. You know, something that I never expected to see, but you know, it's done in that old school kind of claymation, like a kind of animation. John's penis friend is usually referred to as PP or what have you. And every episode he gets into some sort of trouble where, you know, it always starts off with him hanging out in his front lawn. You know, it doesn't look like John has a job. It looks like he's basically a dunce, really. And it's his penis that gets him into a lot of trouble. It doesn't look like he has full control over his penis. It looks like the penis does have a mind of its own. They get into some shenanigans or some troubles, and he has to find a way to correct things and save the day. And then the episodes usually end with him back at home with his mom, grandma, some old lady, watching TV, where somehow the TV episodes or program they're watching recaps the shenanigans of his day. So very short, very clever in a way, I guess I would say, but very interesting nonetheless. So let's go down a brief recap of what you see in every episode. Episode 1, you have him grilling hot dogs, burning himself up, then having to have to walk some dogs, neighborhood dogs, and then dogs go crazy, get loose. Then he has to find a way to wrangle up all the dogs and bring them back to the neighborhood, and there you have it. Episode 2, you know, basically he goes around town and saves the day for many different people. He saves a baby, he helps some kids with their balloons that keep flying away, and he fixes a traffic light. Good for him. Episode 3, it looks like he's looking for a job because his penis decides to break a vase at home. So he's looking for a way to get money. He steals some money from some local performers, buys a new vase, but then figures out that, you know, that wasn't cool what he did. Tries to help them get some money back, and he brings home a brand new vase. Episode 4, you know, he decides to play some games with some locals, which involves a bike race, and yeah, cheats, then realizes that that wasn't cool, plays hide and seek, and his penis acts up, and he has to save the day once again. Episode 5, he wields a gun for some reason, because, you know, that's what you do when you don't have a job, I guess. And then he decides to go hunting. His penis goes crazy, shoots a bunch of stuff, you know, and then he tries to wrangle his penis up and say, stop shooting stuff, and then he ends up shooting his own penis. Ouch, that smarts. In episode 6, he does some garden work and he gets himself into a bunch of trouble. Episode 7, he, you know, decides he wanted something cold to eat, couldn't get it at home, so he goes to the zoo looking for ice cream, while accidentally setting a lion loose. So he has to save the day again, tames the lion back to its pen, saves the children, he gets awarded with a nice ice cream cone, then for some bizarre reason decides to play with a snake, and the snake bites him in the penis. Yep, quality content here, folks. Episode 8, it looks like he joins the local scouts to go camping and does some scout-like activities. And, you know, he decides, or the penis decides, to steal the map, make a paper plane out of it, and everyone gets lost. And thanks to his quick thinking, his penis acts like a pogo stick to go above the tree line and see where everything is to get everyone back home safely. Episode 9, he decides to go fishing. And, you know, his penis, of course, acts like a fishing rod, so, because why wouldn't it? And his penis decides to become quite a jerk and actually pushes the kids in the water. But then he decides, hey, that's not cool, so I gotta save the day. So his penis turns into a helicopter, you know, lowers him down into the water, rescues the kids, and then catches the fish, only for the kids to beat the fish up on his penis. Yep, fun times in the neighborhood. Episode 10, he celebrates his grandmother's day or mother's day or what have you. So he decides to invite the neighborhood over for a party. His penis becomes some party lights, good times had by all. But unfortunately, his penis, because it was electrified, starts a fire. And then he puts out the fire by, once again, you know, the great rescue here of the penis copter comes in handy. And he puts out the fire and good times are had throughout the night. Episode 11 seems to be their Christmas episode, so it's very nice that they have a nice little holiday episode in January. A little late, but hey, who's you know, keeping track of time here? But basically, the episode starts off brilliantly with him making a snowman, and of course, his penis wants to make sure the snowman has an equally long penis like he does. But then he finds Santa and accidentally knocks him down a chimney. He rescues Santa. Santa's unfortunately injured, and John takes his place and delivers all the goodies to all the kids in the neighborhood. And when he gets back home, he has a nice Christmas tree for the house, invites some people over. Uh-oh, no decorations, so what does he do? The penis acts as the decorations and everyone dances around it. Fun. Love it. Episode 12, you know, John, you know, we find out that he has a crush on his neighbor. And, you know, as he's sneaking around, he thought it would be nice if his penis could deliver a rose. But unfortunately, he trips up the postman. Postman gets injured. And now John has to take over his duties and deliver all the mail to the rest of the neighborhood. And lastly, in episode 13, you know, the episode starts off pretty brilliantly again with him playing badminton with himself, thanks to his penis. But then, you know, his mom, grandma says, take out the trash. You need to take the trash out. So, you know, he's trying to chase down the garbage truck and his penis decides, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and take everyone's trash and we're going to all bring it to the dump over there. But there's a long line to the dump and he can't go in. So he can't wait any longer. So he decides to dump all the trash into the water. And you know, everyone was like, hey, you can't do that. So instead of running away, he finally decides, you know what, that wasn't cool. So what does he do? Penis boat. He turns his penis into a boat, jumps into the water, collects all the garbage, and then he does what everyone else would have done, throws the garbage all over the neighborhood just in time for the garbage truck to come over and pick everything up and clean up his mess. So there you have it, John Dillerman, the man and his elongated, stretchy, very well endowed member there. And if you're interested to watch these full episodes, you could check it out on the DR website. That is the Denmark local broadcasting site, I believe. And you can find it in the link below here. And check it out. And if you do decide to check it out, let me know what you think about it. And is this something do you think we'll ever get to see here in the States? My guess is no, but it does look like something that would have came from the minds of those South Park dudes. So enjoy, happy new year, and I'll catch all of y'all next time. Oh, hey guys, thanks again for watching. If you want to check out my other videos, make sure to access them through this menu that you see on this side of the screen. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, or hit that logo you see right here on this side of the screen. I've always wanted to do that. Catch you next time.